हेलो किड्स, गुड इवनिंग, हाउ आर यू ऑल? नमस्ते एंड सलाम वालेकुम। हाय, दिस इज मारिया खान, योर मास्टर टीचर ऑफ बायोलॉजी एट वेदांतु। वेलकम टू माय सेशन। हाय अभिनव, हेलो मयंक, मिशेल, राव हिया, परकवी, राजशेखर, नंदिनी, गुड इवनिंग, वॉर्म वेलकम। हाय मनो, व्हाट्सअप गाइस, व्हाट्सअप। करेक्ट नेम इज अनन्या दत्त शर्मा। करेक्ट नेम इज अनन्या दत्त शर्मा। यप। सो किड्स, वेलकम टू माय सेशन। हाउ आर यू ऑल? एंड टुडे इज द वन शॉर्ट रिवीजन सेशन ऑफ द चैप्टर कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन। भाई आई एम सुपर एक्साइटेड। आर यू ऑल एक्साइटेड? इफ यू ऑल आर एक्साइटेड, हिट ऑन द लाइक बटन, शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स, subscribe to our channel, hit on the bell icon and post me a yo. Come on, show me some josh guys. How's the josh? Rao hiya menti hoga kya? Of course there will be menti. Hi Khushi, hi Amrita. Chalo shuru kare, let's get started. चलो एवरी वन हिट ऑन द लाइक बटन। चलो एंड देन वी प्रोसीड फर्दर। यस खुशी मेंटी होगा। यप। सो किड्स, दिस इज द कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन चैप्टर इन वन शॉट, ब्रॉट टू यू बाय मारिया खान। एंड किड्स, इवन वी हैव अ प्रो एक्सक्लूसिव माइक्रो कोर्स। यू ऑल आर वेल अवेयर ऑफ द माइक्रो कोर्सेज दैट वी हैव ऑन वेदांतुस प्लेटफॉर्म, राइट? So kids, micro courses are chapter based courses and anyone can enroll and you can purchase it. But then we have launched some pro exclusive courses, that is only students who are having V Pro subscription, only they can enroll in this micro courses, and that too free of cost. And all your favorite teachers on YouTube, they have started up with their own micro courses, and I have launched this micro course that is 100% in control and coordination in human beings. So kids, grab the deal now. The course started from 5th of July, and enroll fast, okay, and experience the goodness. And here is the list of Chintu candies. So Srinivas, Amrita Nagraj, Suhita Das, all three of them answered me types of tropic movements. So growth dependent movements are called as tropic movements. So photo, chemo, gravy and hydrotropic movements are the four different type of movements, right? So kids, congratulations. And this is a part of our Prodigy series. So kids, the third segment of the Prodigy series is one shot revision. So the next session will be doubt plus mentee session. And I am super excited for the day. Chalo, so let's get started. Okay? Haan. मैम कितने टाइम का सेशन होगा? प्रोबेबली बेटा 45 मिनट्स टू 1 आवर, ओके, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम अज्यूमिंग। शुरू करें तो किड्स, कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। सो पीपल, देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ कंट्रोल्स, नर्वस कंट्रोल एंड द केमिकल कंट्रोल। नर्वस कंट्रोल इज एक्चुअली कंट्रोल्ड बाय द नर्वस सिस्टम। एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट आवर नर्वस सिस्टम is divided into two types, central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. So kids, if we talk about the central nervous system, the brain and the spinal cord form the central nervous system. The nerves arising from the brain and the nerves arising from the spinal cord form the peripheral nervous system, right? It is because of the nervous system, kids, that is, we are able to receive impulses, we are able to respond and react to various stimuli, right? So to receive this stimuli, all the sense organs, they are having some specialized cells to receive the stimuli, and those cells are called receptors, okay? So in the ear, phonoreceptors, which help in hearing, in the eyes, photoreceptors, which enable us to have vision, okay, rods and cones. And in the skin, we have thermoreceptors. Thermo means heat, they help in sensing the heat. And then in the nose, we have olfactory receptors, which help in detecting the smell. And on the tongue, we have gustatory receptors, which enable us to detect the taste, Okay, so these are five different receptors that we should remember. And kids, the nervous system is of course made up of nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is made up of nerve cells, and nerve cells are also called as neurons, right? So students, there are different type of neurons. Okay, so basically the neurons, depending on their function, they are divided into three types, or they are classified into three types. Sensory neurons, which carry the information from the sense organs to the spinal cord and brain. Second one, motor neurons, which carry the information, impulses, okay, which carry the impulses to the muscles or glands. And the third, interneuron, also known as the association neuron, also known as the relay neuron. They are present in the spinal cord and the brain. So they perform the job of integrating the information, okay. So yes kids, these are the three type of neurons. And if we talk about the neurons, they have these branches called as the dendrites. They have the main body called as the cell body. Within the cell body, there's a nucleus, and then there's a long process called as the axon. Axon has endings called as the axon terminal. Am I correct, guys? Yeah. So now kids, when we talk about the transmission of a nerve impulse, first of all, this impulse which travel, they're always in the form of electrical. They are electrical in nature. Okay, so whenever there is any change in the surroundings, okay, in the sense organs, any change, okay, the information is picked up. The information is picked up by the tips of the dendrites of this neuron. This induces a chemical reaction, which leads to the production of a an electrical impulse. I repeat again, any information is picked up by the tips of dendrites. It causes a chemical reaction which leads to the production of an electrical impulse. This electrical impulse travels from the dendrites to the cell body, from the cell body to the axon, from the axon to the axon terminal or to the nerve endings. Okay, now in between two neurons, there's a small gap, and this gap is called as a synapse. Now in this synapse, some chemicals are released from the knobs present in the axon terminal, and these chemicals are called as what? Bachcho, these chemicals are called as what? Can anyone tell me these chemicals are called as what? Come on. Michelle, Zainab, perfect. It's neurotransmitters, right? Example, acetylcholine. So yes, the impulse travels from the tips of the dendrites to the cell body, from the cell body to the axon, from the axon to the nerve endings, from the nerve endings through the synapse to the tips of the dendrites of the next neuron, right? And finally, the impulse is delivered to the muscles or glands where the action is brought about, where the change is seen. Am I correct? Yeah. And then kids, any immediate or involuntary action that we perform is called as a reflex action. I told you in the previous session, like when I visited a doctor's clinic, I had a knee pain. Basically, I had a ligament tear, and when the doctor had hit my knee with the help of this instrument, okay, hammer-like instrument, I actually unintentionally kicked the doctor. So people, when I kick the doctor, it's unintentional. Okay, I did it immediately, so it was immediate. I did not do intentionally, so it was involuntary action. So any immediate and involuntary action which is given as a response towards a stimulus, hitting with the hammer-like structure was a stimulus, it's called as a reflex action. Now reflex actions are immediate, and that's the reason why reflex actions are coordinated by the spinal cord. Once the action is complete, then the information is delivered to the brain. But reflex action are coordinated by the spinal cord. And the path which a reflex action follows is called as a reflex arm. So the information from the receptors is passed on to the sensory neuron, to the association neuron, to the motor neuron, and finally to the effector organ, which can be a muscle or a gland. So I call this pathway as RSAME: receptor, sensory, association, motor, and effector. R sa me. So people, what are you asking here? Beta, I was engrossed in teaching. I was engrossed in teaching. And Abhinav beta, I always ensure that if I spot the queries, I make sure I answer. Okay? Ma'am, I don't understand that why myelin sheath, what is myelin sheath and nodes of Langer? Okay. So axon is covered by fatty layer. And that fatty layer is called myelin sheath. Myelin sheath is not continuous. Myelin sheath is discontinuous. Okay? So the gaps in between the myelin sheath are called nodes of Ranvier. Okay? Theek hai Rao, here I hope the answer is given to you. Okay, the query is cleared. Cool. Chalo. Let's proceed further. Now kids, let's move on to the human nervous system. As I mentioned earlier, the human nervous system is divided into two parts. Central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. Okay? So if we talk about the central nervous system, it is made up of brain and the spinal cord. If we talk about the peripheral nervous system, it is divided into two parts. Somatic nervous system and the autonomic nervous system. Somatic nervous system is made up of nerves that arise from the brain called as the cranial nerves. So we have 12 pair of cranial nerves and spinal nerves which arise from the spinal cord. So we have 31 pair of spinal cord. Okay, 31 pair of spinal nerves, not spinal cord, 31 pair of spinal cord. Perfect. And kids, the cranial nerves are a combination of sensory nerve and motor nerve. For example, optic nerve. See, we can actually have a vision with the help of our eyes, sensory nerve. Our eyeballs can actually move, motor nerves. So, the cranial nerves are a combination of sensory and motor nerves. Okay, perfect. And then kids, the autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system is made up of two parts. Sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. So sympathetic nervous system enables your body to face any flight or fight situation. Okay? It actually causes adrenaline rush and it is responsible for several changes in your body. For example, dilation of pupils, increase in the heartbeat, increase in the respiration rate, breathing rate. Okay, so yeah, that's the job of sympathetic nervous system. And then when we talk about parasympathetic nervous system, it brings calmness, soothing effect to your body. For example, you are enjoying the ride, roller coaster ride. That time you're too excited and you're nervous, okay, you experience something in your belly, henna, and that's because of the sympathetic nervous system. But once the ride is over, you feel like khatam, relax, but I enjoyed. So that is caused by the parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, so yeah, sympathetic nervous system causes adrenaline rush, and yes, Mayank, PDFs will be uploaded soon. Okay, yeah, cool. Yes. And then let us move on to the brain and the spinal cord. So kids, brain is divided into three parts: forebrain, midbrain, and the hindbrain. People, forebrain, cerebrum, thalamus, and hypothalamus. So cerebrum, it is divided into two parts: right cerebral hemisphere and left cerebral hemisphere, which wraps itself around the thalamus. And underneath the thalamus, there's a small region called as the hypothalamus. Now people, forebrain has several regions which receive information from our sense organs. Okay, and this information is associated with the previous experiences, integrated with the previous experiences, and then motor signaling is done. So the relay of the sensory signaling and motor signaling, it occurs at the thalamus. Okay, and then underneath the thalamus, this hypothalamus, which controls a lot of involuntary actions. Okay, hunger, thirst, these are all controlled by the hypothalamus. Perfect. Then comes the midbrain. People, midbrain acts as a relay center between the forebrain and the hindbrain. Okay, it helps in passing on the messages. Perfect. And then kids, if we talk about the hindbrain is made up of three parts: pons medulla and cerebellum. Okay, now kids, pons, it acts as a relay center between the hindbrain and the cerebrum, between the cerebellum and the cerebellum. Besides, it holds one respiratory center out of three. Medulla, it controls involuntary actions of our internal organs. Okay, and it is also called as a respiratory center because there are two respiratory centers. And Srishti Panwar Beta, we don't need to draw a brain because in our first semester, that is SA1, that is going to happen, we will not be asked any question to draw the diagram. But diagram based questions will definitely be asked. So identify the correct label, identify the correct function. So this kind of questions Srishti Pawar can be asked. Okay? Theek hai? Yep. And then cerebellum helps in coordinating voluntary activities. See, cerebrum controls voluntary activities. Cerebellum coordinates voluntary activities. And medulla terminates into spinal cord. Okay? Perfect. Yep. And then, kids, let's move on to the endocrine system. So, endocrine system is made up of endocrine glands. And endocrine glands, they are the ductless glands because they pour in their secretion, that is hormones, directly into the bloodstream. The hormones, they are secreted by the glands and they are carried away by the blood to the target cells, and the target cells are usually away from the source of secretion. Hormones are always secreted in minute quantities. Hormones are never stored in our body. Excess of hormones, they are eliminated out of the body. Okay, they are excreted out of the body. Perfect. And Anisha, I have already explained reflex action. You can watch the recap. Okay? Perfect. Cool. Yep. And then, kids, here when we talk about the endocrine gland, so bacha, pituitary gland, it secretes the growth hormone, which is responsible for the growth of our body. It causes elongation of the bones. So hypersecretion of growth hormone causes gigantism. Undersecretion of the hormone causes dwarfism. Okay, and then thyroid hormone, thyroid gland secretes thyroxine. Okay, it secretes a hormone, thyroxine. Now kids, thyroxine regulates our basal metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. That is, it helps in the breakdown of these food molecules to produce heat, which can be utilized for maintaining a constant temperature of the body. Now, hypersecretion of thyroxine and hyposecretion of thyroxine both can cause issues. Okay, so kids, hyposecretion of thyroxine may cause goiter. Okay, and hyposecretion can cause thyroxine. Hyposecretion can cause goiter. Okay, hyposecretion can cause goiter, and hypersecretion can cause exophthalmic goiter. Okay, hyposecretion can cause goiter, and hypersecretion can cause exophthalmic goiter. Okay, wherein the eyeballs protrude out. Okay, yep. Yes, yes, Amrita Nagraj. Soon those kind of sessions are lined up already. Okay. Over secretion is known as hypersecretion, under secretion is known as hyposecretion. Okay, Anish? Yep. Haan. And then, adrenal gland, fitting like a cap above the kidneys. Adrenal gland secretes two hormones, adrenaline and noradrenaline. So, adrenaline activates your sympathetic nervous system, noradrenaline activates your parasympathetic nervous system. So, adrenaline prepares your body for the fight or flight mechanism. Noradrenaline prepares your body for the calmness, soothing effect. Okay, on top of both the kidneys. Okay, and then pancreas, it is a leaf-like gland present below and behind the stomach. Okay, it secretes two hormones, insulin and glucagon. Insulin converts excess of glucose into glycogen, which is stored inside the liver. And glucagon converts glycogen into glucose and releases into the blood when our body experiences low concentration of glucose in the blood. Okay, Then ovaries are present in females, which secrete estrogen responsible for the development of secondary sexual characters in females. Okay, and testes in males, which are responsible for the secondary sexual characters in males. Okay, and Anish, I would recommend you to watch my previous session. Okay, hormonal coordination in human beings. There you will find all the things related to this particular segment. Okay, this is a one-shot revision session. And that's the reason why we like cover it up in a very short span. Okay, yeah, I won't go in detail. Already a detailed session is out there. Do watch. Okay, so kids, if you're understanding and enjoying, hit on the like button, share, subscribe, and post me a yo, guys. Everyone, post me a yo, yo, guys. Perfect. Okay, cretinism is a disorder caused in children due to malfunctioning of thyroid gland. Okay, cool. Aage badhte. Now, kids, coordination in plants. So there are two type of movements: growth dependent movements and growth independent movements. So the movement exhibited by the plant, which are completely dependent on the growth of the plant, such kind of movements are called as growth dependent movement, also called as the tropic movement. For example, when the plant grows, okay, the shoot system is growing as well as the plant is moving, growth dependent. When the roots are growing, the plant is moving, growth dependent. Okay, so yeah, the movement is dependent on the growth. And growth independent, like mimosa leaflets, they shut when we touch, it's growth independent. And growth independent movement is also known as the nastic movement. Okay, now kids, the growth dependent movements, based on the stimuli, they are classified into four types: phototropic, geotropic, chemotropic, and hydrotropic. So photo means light. When the movement is towards or away from the source of light, okay, it is known as phototropism. Geo means gravity, it is also known as gravitropism. So when the movement is towards or away from gravity, like roots of the plant, it is known as gravitropism. When it is towards or away from a chemical, it is called as chemotropism. When it is towards or away from water, it is hydrotropism. Okay, so these are various tropic movements. So bachcha, the shoot of the plant bending towards the source of light, phototropism. The roots moving deep into the soil towards gravity, gravitropism. The pollen tube growing towards the ovule, chemotropism. The roots of the plant growing towards in search of water, it's called as hydrotropism. Okay, and then the growth independent movements are called as nastic movements. Okay, like Venus flytrap, trapping the insects, or it can be the leaf of mimosa, leaflets of mimosa, which open or shut. Okay, and yeah, these are the nastic movements. Now people, the broad difference between the nastic and the tropic movements: one is growth independent and the second one is growth dependent. Now when it is growth dependent, growth is always very slow, so these movements are slow. But the nastic movement, the responses are immediate, like leaflets immediately shut. But when in case of sunflower, it moves from east to west slowly, so it can be immediate or it can be slow. Okay, now the tropic movements, they are directional. They can be towards the stimulus, which we call it as positive movement. They can be away from the stimulus, which we call it as negative movements. Okay, then the nastic movements, they are non-directional, they are like random. Okay, so yeah, they are non-directional. And nastic movements, why exactly do they occur? It is because of the movement of hormones along with water and ions. So when everything moves out, it changes the turgor pressure. So nastic movement is due to change in turgor pressure. Tropic movements occur because of cell division. So rapid cell division leads to the addition of new cells, and finally it leads to the growth of the plant part. Okay, and then examples we already discussed. So kids, did you enjoy? If you all enjoyed, post me a yo in the chats, like, share, subscribe, and a yo. Come on, everyone. Cool. I can see 47 likes. Can we make it to 55, kids? 55? Ho sakta hai kya? ओके सो बच्चों, तर्जनी टर्जिडिटी बेटा सृष्टि, व्हेन द सेल बिकम्स टर्जिड द प्लांट पार्ट ओपन्स अप और ब्लूम्स, व्हेन इट लूजेस टर्जिडिटी इट बिकम्स फ्लैसिड एंड श्रिंक्स. ओके यप कूल. एंड देन गाइस, प्लांट हार्मोन्स, फोर टाइप ऑफ प्लांट हार्मोन्स, ऑक्सिन, जिबरेलिन, साइटोकाइनिन एंड एब्सिसिक एसिड. ऑक्सिन्स कॉज शूट सेल एलोंगेशन एंड दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई द शूट टिप्स ऑफ द प्लांट दे कीप ऑन ग्रोइंग. ओके जिबरेलिन दे कॉज स्टेम सेल एलोंगेशन एंड दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई द इंटर नोड्स ऑफ अ प्लांट दे कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग इन लेंथ. साइटोकाइनिन, साइटो मीन्स सेल एंड काइनिन मीन्स डिविजन. सो साइटोकाइनिन promotes cell division and that's the reason why the flower is able to bloom, I mean the bud is able to bloom into a beautiful flower. Now auxin, gibberellin and cytokinin, these three hormones are growth promoters. Okay, but abscisic acid is growth inhibitor, it inhibits growth. Okay, it is also called as a stress hormone because it leads to the wilting of leaves. Okay, and menti hoga bachcho, menti hoga. Yep. So now kids, how many of you are already an enrolled students of Vedantu? Batao. Kitne log Vedantu ke enrolled students hain? Chalo 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 chalo, tell me. And how many of you haven't yet enrolled with Vedantu? How many of you haven't enrolled with Vedantu? Now kids, do you know that your essay 1 is going to be completely objective based? Essay 1 is completely objective based. How are you going to prepare for this examination? Vedantu has its plan ready. We have our plan ready for essay 1. Achha. Can you tell me some of the problems that you all face for preparing for your examination? Problem. Tell me your problem statements. Problem number one, ki ma'am, managing all six subjects is a big deal. Do you all agree? Ki I love biology, but I hate SS like anything. And eventually my marks tanked down in SS and my overall score came down. So balancing all the six subjects is a big deal. Yes or no? Yes or no, guys? Yes? Hai na? For every one of us, each one of us, some subject is favorite and some subject we hate or we ignore. Then, second thing, the second most concern, notes. Ma'am, which notes to follow? Which publication to follow? Shall I refer to the textual language or is it okay if I write the answers in my own words? That is also a problem. Do you all agree? Huh. So Prasanna is saying, ma'am, I have Tattva. Yes, bacho, at Vedantu, those who enroll with us for an entire academic year, we provide them with Tattva, specialized notes. So, bhai, Tattva are ekdam notes curated by experts that we provide to our students who enroll with us for an entire academic year. Then, third concern, doubts. Yes or no? Ma'am, whenever I study, I get 10 doubts and if those doubts are not resolved, I get stuck then and there. Yes or no? At least this was my particular issue. In physics, I could not understand what's velocity, what's acceleration, what's force, what's pressure, and then my marks were also tie fish. VIP is still available. Yep, Mohammed Sami, VIP is still available. And yes, Tattva are so awesome. And then, what about extra preparation? What about if you miss a certain session? So kids, these are our usual concerns which we have it when we are studying. Yes or no? Yes? So here at Vedantu, we have solved all your concerns. And that's the reason why when you enroll with Vedantu, you can definitely score 100% marks, 100% knowledge. You can actually fulfill your dream. Whatever is your dream, whatever is your goal, you can achieve it. Okay? Kids, first of all, we have live sessions for all the six subjects. Physics, Chem, Bio, English, Maths, SS. All the six subjects. And that's the reason why when best teachers from the country come and teach you, you actually become the best possible version of your own self. That's point number one. Then, point number two. Each of our session has 8 to 10 amazing high level quizzes. Much amazing and fabulous than the mentee. Okay? And kids, when you actually participate in all these kind of quizzes, okay, when you participate in all these kind of quizzes, so when you participate in all these kind of quizzes, you actually ace in your final performance, right? And here you get to participate in the quizzes and compete along with students across the globe. Okay, so yes, we show you the fastest fingers list, we show you the leaderboard, we show you your overall class rank, we show you the points that you have earned. So yes, bachcho, tell me, after this much of practice, won't your performance in your SA1 be super amazing? Don't you think so? You know what, Khushi? We have students from 35 plus countries. So you actually get the competitive feel. Yes. And then, bachcha, notes. If you enroll with us for an entire academic year, of course we provide you special curated notes that are Tattva. But even if you enroll with us for a month, you can download the premium handwritten notes provided by the master teacher in the form of a PDF. Yes, that is a provision. So yes, you can avail the PDF of the session. Acha. Doubts? Each of our session has a well-experienced, well-qualified, classy class teacher who solves your doubt. And when your doubts are resolved, you get a better understanding. For your extra preparation, we provide you with assignments, we provide you with tests. There's monthly test, mid-yearly test, annual test, chapter-based test. And finally, you ace in your examinations. Okay? So yes, doubts are taken care of. Your additional preparation is taken care of. And on top of that, we provide you personalized report card. You get to know, achha, these are my strong subjects, these are my weak subjects. This is the topic where I need to rework. This is the topic where I am already good. And how you can improve, we give you that kind of a personalized report card. Okay? And then in case you miss a particular session, you can always watch the replay. And even the replays are interactive. We have interactive replay, guys. And when you watch our interactive replays, even while watching the replays, you can play quizzes, live quizzes, you can get to see your name flashing on the leaderboard. So replay hai, but it is not like a replay. And on top of that, you get micro courses, crash courses, absolutely free of cost. Absolutely free of cost. So whether they are chapter-based micro courses or whether they are crash courses for your competitive examinations, for your board preparations, for your personality development or any non-academic concerns, these will be provided to you absolutely free of cost. So kids, actually the benefits that you avail over here with Vedantu, they are endless. So chalo, grab the deal now. And then, icing on the cake, cherry on the pie, we are offering you VIP, that is Vedantu Improvement Promise. It states that if you enroll with us for an entire academic year, you will definitely seek an improvement in your scores. And if there's no improvement, we return back your entire course fee. No questions asked. The only condition is 75% attendance in our live sessions and 75% completion of the assigned tests. You fulfill these requirements and we assure you the promise. So now kids, are you interested in enrolling with Vedantu? Yes, Mr. Unknown, are you interested? Batao mujhe. Yes, Mayuri. So kids, click on this link given in the description or in the pinned comment, and it will divert you to a website wherein your grade, your board, your academic year gets automatically selected. And on top of that, even my coupon code gets automatically applied. And my coupon code is MAC Pro. MA Maria K for Khan Pro. V Pro courses, na? So that's the reason why MAC Pro. Let me actually take you to the website and show you this. Okay? So, kahan pe hu main? Yahan. Okay. So here is the YouTube video. Okay, one of my YouTube sessions. And kids, when let me make myself smaller. Okay, when we scroll it further down, okay, here we get to see a link in the pinned comment. Can you see all? Okay, click on this link. Okay, see grade 10 CBSE 2022 automatically select. And all the basic features like unlimited live classes, study material assignments, in-class doubt solving, interactive replays, assignments and notes, all these basic features are provided to you with our ProLite subscription. But then, if you want a doubt solving app outside the class to resolve your academic queries, you can choose the Pro Classic subscription. On top of that, if you want a personal mentor to cater to your academic and non-academic concerns throughout the academic journey, you can choose a Pro Plus subscription. Okay? Now, of course, bachcho, the price will vary. Like if I talk about the Pro Lite one, okay, so the annual subscription would cost you ₹29,699. It is already providing you 10% additional discount with my coupon code. You can ease out the burden of paying all at once by opting our EMI option, which starts at 2475 only. But still, I will recommend you try out a 1 month subscription, which is merely at 2340. The Pro Classic one would cost you ₹2970 per month and ₹39149 annually. And then the Pro Plus one would cost you ₹4230 monthly and ₹50399 annually. I guess you would have made your mind. If not, let me convince you by taking you to our website. Okay. So kids, have a look at this dashboard. This is my dashboard, Maria's dashboard. So when I go to my sessions, I can get to see past or upcoming sessions. So when I go to past sessions, I can click on get notes and download the PDF of that particular session instantly, huh? Just a single click away in the form of a PDF. Okay, see the PDF is getting loaded. Okay, yep. And yes guys, it's taking normal than the usual, maybe because of my net. Okay, yep, let it load. So see, these are like session notes. Can you see, hai na? Everything, handwritten notes are provided. So yeah, with all the annotations. And then if you wish to watch the replay, let me like get back. Yeah, so you can click on this and you may watch the replay. Okay, you can actually watch the replay. So yeah, why it is like full screen? Escape. Bhai, my net is not like operating with me. Chalo, we'll watch this replay. Okay. So see, you can actually watch the replay. You can go to whichever slide that you want. Okay, whichsoever slide that you want. Okay, and then you can see over here. See how many quizzes were asked in this particular session. And then if I scroll it further down, okay, you can see 65 doubts asked and 65 doubts resolved. Right? So, bachcho, now that you are pretty convinced, you can move over here. Okay. And when you scroll on this particular window further down, you get to see Purchase Star Pro. Pro Lite is more than enough for everyone, okay? Purchase Pro Lite subscription, that's more than enough. And I'll say ki try out a 1 month subscription. And this 2310 is pretty nominal. You know guys, Why it is nominal? Because when you divide it with the number of sessions that you attend, for example, let's consider that you're attending 230 sessions a month. So it roughly comes down to 2340 divided by 230. Okay, it comes down to approximately 10 rupee per session, right? So it's much cheaper than the mask that you purchase nowadays, much cheaper than the auto fare. So guys, grab the deal now, grab the deal now, hai na? And now people, it's time to get little bit senti. Let's play some menti. Are you all guys menti ready, menti ready, menti ready? Menti ready? Yes. Okay. So chalo, let's play little bit menti. Just a sec. Abhinav, beta, if we don't advertise na, all these YouTube sessions cannot happen. It is because of which we get students, it is because of which we get salaries, it is because of which we get enrollments, and because of which we are able to cater to the masses. Hai na? Code hai mein, mera beta Shrishti, MAK Mac Pro, PRO, Mac Pro, okay? And menti code is here. I'm flashing it now. 8871762 0. 8871762 0. Come on, come on, come on. Join in, guys. Join in. Join in. Everyone join in fast. Chalo, come on. And 59 likes. Can we make it to 70? Can we make it to 70? Chalo, guys. So, people, here we go. First quiz, flashing on your screens now. The receptor which helps to detect the smell are known as smell. Phonoreceptors, photoreceptors, thermoreceptors, olfactory receptors, which receptors? Come on, 5 seconds left. Okay, 21 kids answered it olfactory, and that's absolutely right, bachcho, that's absolutely right. And yes, it's olfactory receptors. Okay, chalo, second quiz, second quiz, second quiz. Everyone. Second question flashes on your screens now. And today I will display you the leaderboard only for the last two questions. These neurons send signals to a muscle or a gland. Sensory, motor, inter, none of the above. Come on, guys, come on. Come on, come on, come on. 17 kids answered motor neuron, and yes, bachcho, it's motor neuron. Okay, and then let's proceed further. with the third quiz. Shankar Rekha, I could not understand whatever you are saying. Third question flashing on your screens now. A special case of involuntary movement where a voluntary organ is pulled away from the danger to save itself. Immediate and involuntary action. Thinking, reflex action, reflex arc, endocrine action. Batao. Batao, batao, batao. A, B, C, D. Chalo, come on, kids, come on. Again, 21 of you answered it right. And yes, mere bachcho, it's reflex action, and the path that it follows is called as a reflex arc. Okay? So, yes, here is the leaderboard after three questions. So, Mr. Expert, Krishna, Soni, Vishishtha, Mayang, Sakshi, Teddy, Boti Girl, student Mayuri, lovely, congratulations, and let's proceed further. Yes, beta, I am reading the comments. Chalo. Fourth one, here. Answer first to get more points, okay? The path through which nerve signals involved in a reflex action travel, the path, what is the path called as, guys? The path is called as, just now I answered it accidentally. Thinking, reflex action, reflex arc, endocrine action. Batao, batao, batao. Everyone, everyone, A, B, C, D. Come on. Thank you, Sheikh Afreen. Come on. Most of you are saying it, C. एटीन किड्स आंसर इट रिफ्लेक्स आर्क एंड येस मेरे प्यारे बच्चों ऑफकोर्स इट्स रिफ्लेक्स आर्क ओके सो कृष्ण सोनी विशिष्ट मयंक टेडी बोटिकल लवली स्वीटी हिया वॉटसन मिशेल कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन हाय श्री हरि एंड लेट्स प्रोसीड फर्दर ओके Fifth question now, I'll directly show you the final leaderboard, okay? Dash pair of cranial nerves are found in the human body. How many pair of cranial nerves? Come on. How many pair of cranial nerves? 31, 12, 62, 24. Everyone confused between A and B? So, bachu, remember 1, 2, 3, 1. 12 pair of cranial nerves and 31 pair of spinal nerves. So, 23 kids answered it right. And let's proceed to the next quiz. Sixth question, flashing on your screens now. So in response for fight or flight response in human body, Mohammed Samish, 9 months are pending, March, April, 9. In human, Dash is responsible for fight or flight response in human body. Sympathetic nervous system, parasympathetic nervous system, central nervous system, none of the above. Batao, batao. Adrenaline activates which system? Which? Kya baat hai? 16 kids answered it. Sympathetic nervous system. Yes, people. Calmness and digest is by parasympathetic. Fight or flight is by sympathetic. And central nervous system, brain and spinal cord. Okay. Then moving further. Let's see the leaderboard here. Points are added. Krishna Soni, Vishishta, Mayank, lovely Teddy Gupta, here, Sweetie Watson, Michelle, Mr. Expert, congrats, and last and the final one. Here we go. Chalo. Kids, like, share, subscribe, otherwise I won't show you the leaderboard. Dash inhibits growth and causes wilting of leaves. Which is a growth inhibitor? Which hormone is called as growth inhibitor? Like, share, subscribe. 64 likes. Can we make it to 75? Auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, abscisic acid. 3, 2, 1. Time up. 17 kids have answered it right. And what do you feel, who will be topping the leaderboard? Thank you for your compliment, Midnight Artist. And by the way, the spelling of boring is b-o-r-i-n-g, and you are very interesting. Krishna Soni, congratulations with 6,847 points. Congratulations. Okay. And great job done, kids. Are you all enjoying? So, bacho, let me tell you, the new batches have already started from 5th of July. So, grab your seats now and prepare. Get prepared for your SA1 and SA2 amazingly well with Vedantu. And you know the link has been put up in the description, also in the pinned comment, and you know my coupon code, that is Mac Pro, right? So that's it, people. And now here is the homework for the day. Enlist the plant hormones and their functions. Okay, a very simple question for you all. Post your answer in the chat box comment section. Top three students, their names will be flashed in my upcoming session as my official Chintu Candies. And here, kids, I asked a question in the previous session of Vedantu Olympiad Wizard. I gave you a link, also Google Form link, wherein you can post your answers. So maximum students who answer it right, they may stand a chance to get it enrolled for free in our foundation batches. Okay, so bacho, here was the question. A zygote which has X chromosome inherited from father will develop into a... So people, egg always has X. If the sperm carries X, the resultant zygote will have XXX chromosomes, and that's the reason why a girl child will be born, right? So a daughter will be born. So bacho, that was the answer, and keep participating in our contests. You may never know that you stand an opportunity to enroll with us for absolutely free. Okay. And thank you so much for being with me right till the end of the session, kids. Let's meet in the upcoming session. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Milo Wapis. And keep watching Vedantu. Bye-bye. Love you all.